पटेल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल. टुडेज अवर टॉपिक इज स्टेट ट्रांजिशन मैट्रिक्स फॉर द डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिस्टम इन द यूनिट नंबर 2, द कंटीन्यूअस टाइम स्टेट स्पेस एनालिसिस टू द डिस्क्रीट टाइम स्टेट स्पेस एनालिसिस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, how we have to find the value of state transition matrix. So we have already studied in the last session. The following methods are used to find the value of state transition matrix, and the state transition matrix is known as the value of k. So we can use two methods. The first one is the Kelly-Hamilton method, and the second one is the using the Z transformation method. So we have studied in the last example how the Kelly-Hamilton method is applied to find out the value of phi of k or the g raised to k, and then we have to find the value of y of k. So today we will study about using the Z transformation method to find out the value of state transition matrix. Okay, so example, obtain the state transition matrix of the following discrete time system, and the equation is given x of k plus 1 is equal to g x of k plus h u of k, and y of k is equal to c x of k, where the g matrix is given at g is equal to 0 1 minus 0.60 minus 1, h is equal to 1 1, c is equal to 1 0, and then we have to obtain the state x of k and output y of k, where input is applied is state step input, that means u of k is equal to 1 for the k is equal to 0 1 2 up to infinite. Okay, so this is our example. So first of all, we have assume the initial state. The initial state is also given in the example, x of 0 that is equal to x1 of 0, x2 of 0 that is equal to 1 minus 1. So first we obtain the value of zi minus z inverse. In the last session we will find the value of state transition matrix using the Kelly-Hamilton method. So as you remember, in the Kelly-Hamilton method, first of all we have to find the value of lambda, and then we have to find the value of b0 and b1. Here we have used the Z transformation method. So first target is we have to find out the value of zi minus z inverse. Here the value of z matrix is given. So what is the equation for zi minus z inverse? That also we have discussed in the previous video. So the zi minus z inverse is equal to the adjoint of zi minus z upon the mod of zi minus z. Okay, so first of all we have to find the value of adjoint of zi minus z. So the equation for adjoint is we have to find the value of a1, a2 and a3, and then we have to find the value of h1, h2 and h3. So what is the equation of a1? A1 is equal to minus stress g. So is equal to minus stress the matrix g. So we have to find the sum of the diagonal element, and then we have to take the trace. So what is the trace? Trace is nothing but the sum of the diagonal element. So 0 minus 1 is equal to minus 1, and minus trace that is equal to plus 1. Now h1 is equal to g plus a1i. So put the value of g and a1 in this equation. So g is equal to 0 1 minus 0.60 minus 1, and a1i that is equal to, we can get a1 is equal to 1, so 1 0 0 1. We have to simply add these two matrix, we can get h1 is equal to 1 1 minus 0.60 and 0. Clear? Now next is we have to find the value of a2. An equation of a2 is equal to minus 1 by 2 trace g into h1. So first of all we have to multiply these two matrix g into h1, and then we have to take the trace, and then we have to divide this value by 2. So g into h1 is equal to 0 1 minus 0.60 minus 1, and 1 1 minus 0.60 0. Here you know the g matrix is given, and h1 matrix that we have to find earlier. So we have to simply multiplication of these two matrix, we can get minus 0.60, 0, 1.32 and minus 0.60. So the trace of the minus 0.16, 0, 1.32 minus 0.16 is nothing but the 1.32 divided by 2. So we can get A2 is equal to 0.60. Okay, now next is we have to find the value of H2. So H2 is equal to G into H1 plus A2 into I. You have already multiplication of G into H1. So answer of the G into H1 is given here. So simply put this answer in this equation, and plus we have to multiply the A2 with the I matrix. So we can get 0.16. Simply we have to add these two matrix, we can get 0 0 0 0. So answer of H2 is equal to 0. Okay, so next we don't have to find the value of A3 because we can get H2 is equal to 0. Now we have to prepare the equation of adjoint of Zi minus C. So we can get Zi minus C starting from the last term, A2 into Z raised to 0 plus A1 into Z plus Z square. So Z square as it is, A1 is equal to 1, that we have to find, and A2 is equal to 0.60. So the equation will become mod of Zi minus C is equal to Z square plus Z plus 0.60. Now next, the equation for the adjoint of Zi minus Z is equal to Iz plus H1. Okay, if we can get the value of H2. So what is the equation of adjoint of Zi minus Z? It is Iz square plus H1z plus H2. Okay, if we can get the value of H3. So what is the equation of adjoint of Zi minus Z? It is Iz cube plus H1z square plus H2z plus H3. So depending the value of the H1, H2 and H3, we have to prepare the equation of adjoint of Zi minus Z. Here the value of H2 is equal to 0. So we can simply put the value H1 and plus I into Z. Okay, so what is the I into Z? It is Z0, 0, Z, and H1, that is we have to find, we have to simply add these two matrix, and we can get Z plus 1, 1, minus 0.16 and Z. Now the first target is we have to find the value of Zi minus Z inverse. So equation of Zi minus Z is equal to adjoint of Zi minus Z upon mod of Zi minus Z. So simply we can put the value of this. Now we have to simplify this equation. We can get Z plus 1 upon Z square plus Z plus 0.16, 1 upon Z square plus Z plus 0.16, minus 0.16 upon Z square plus Z plus 0.16, and Z upon Z square plus Z plus 0.16. Okay, now we have to find the factor of this denominator, and it is 0.2 and 0.8. So the matrix will become Z plus 1 upon Z plus 0.2, Z plus 0.8. The another term is 1 upon Z plus 0.2, Z plus 0.8. The third term is minus 0.16 upon Z plus 0.2, Z plus 0.8. The fourth one is the Z upon Z plus 0.2 and Z plus 0.8. Now the next is we have to find the value of A and B using the partial fraction factor. Why we have to find the factor of this denominator term? Because we have to find the value of the A and B using the partial fraction, and the partial fraction is not applicable for the Z square term. So we have to first factorize the denominator, and then we have to find the value of A and B using the partial fraction for each of the four term. So we can get 4 by 3 upon Z plus 0.2 plus minus 1 by 3 upon Z plus 0.8. The second term is 5 by 3 upon Z plus 0.2 plus minus 5 by 3 upon Z plus 0.8. And the third term is minus 0.8 by 3 upon Z plus 0.2 plus 0.8 by 3 upon Z plus 0.8. And the fourth term is minus 1 by 3 Z plus 0.2 and plus 4 by 3 Z plus 0.8. So this is the answer of Zi minus C inverse. Okay, now what is our target? What we have to find? We have to find the value of state transition matrix. And the state transition matrix is nothing but the phi of k or the g raised to k. So now phi of k is equal to g raised to k. Okay, and what is the equation of the state transition matrix using the Z transformation method? It is the Z inverse in the bracket Zi minus Z inverse into Z. Okay, so this is the equation to find out the state transition matrix that we have to study in the theory portion. Okay, so put the value of Zi minus Z inverse in this equation and then take the inverse Z. Okay, so put the value of Zi minus Z inverse, and here also you have to note it, Zi minus Z inverse into Z. So we have to multiply this Z with the each term. Okay, so we can get this type of matrix. Clear? Okay, now next we have to find the inverse Z for this particular each term. So the Z inverse of 4 by 3 into Z upon Z plus 0.2. So the constant term, there is no Z inverse, but the Z inverse of Z upon Z plus 0.2, it is nothing but the minus 0.2 raised to k. Okay, 1 by 3 as it is, and Z upon Z plus 0.8, the Z inverse of Z upon Z plus 0.8 is minus 0.8 raised to k. So same method is applied for the all the terms, and we can get this type of matrix. So this is the answer for only state transition matrix. Okay, now next we have to find the value of x of k that is given in the example. Okay, so what is the equation for x of z? First of all, we have to find the value of x of z, and then we have to find the value of inverse z inverse of x of z, that is equal to x of k. So what is the equation of x of z? That also we have to prove in the theory section. So x of z is equal to Zi minus z inverse z x of 0 plus Zi minus z inverse h u of z. So here the value of Zi minus Z inverse that already we have to find, the value of x of 0, initial condition, that is given in the question, the value of H matrix is also given, and what is U of Z? It is the unique step input that is also given in this question. So first of all, we have to find the value of U of Z. So U of K is our step input. Okay, in the exam, they will also given the ramp input, parabolic input, impulse input. So according to the input, you have to find the Z transform of this particular input signal. Here the step input is given, so we can find the value of U of Z, and the Z transform of the step input that we have to find in the chapter number 1, it is nothing but the 1 upon 1 minus Z inverse is equal to Z upon Z minus 1. Okay, now next x of z, we have to common out the term Zi minus z inverse. So in this bracket, z into x of 0 plus h into u of z. So first of all, we have to find the value of z into x of 0 plus h into u of z. So the z into x of 0 plus h into u of z. So x of 0 is given in the equation 1 minus 1. Okay, and into z. So we can get the matrix z minus z plus H matrix is given, that is 1, 1, and U of Z, that is we have to find, it is Z upon Z minus 1. So Z upon Z minus 1 into 1, 1. So we can get Z upon Z minus 1, Z upon Z minus 1. Now simply we have to add these two matrix, we can get Z square upon Z minus 1, and the second term is minus Z square plus 2Z upon Z minus 1. Okay, now the next is we have to find the X of Z. So put the value of Zi minus Z inverse and x Z x of 0 plus h u of 0 in this equation. We can get this type of matrix. Okay, this is the value of the Zi minus Z inverse, and this is the value of x of 0 into Z plus h u of Z. Okay, we have to multiply these two matrix and we can get this type of matrix. Now here you can see that if we have to simplify this matrix in the numerator term, some term will be cancelled out and we can get x of z like this manner, z in this bracket, z square plus 2 upon z plus 0.2, z plus 0.8 and z minus 1. And the second factor is z in this bracket minus z square plus 1.84z upon z plus 0.2, z plus 0.8 and z minus 1. Now simply you have to find the value of a, b, c using the partial fraction method. Okay, so first term, z square plus 2 upon z plus 0.2, z plus 0.8, z minus 1 is equal to a upon z plus 0.2 plus b upon z plus 0.8 plus c upon z minus 1. Clear? So first of all, put z is equal to, so first of all we have to simplify this equation. We can get z square plus 2, that is equal to a z plus 0.8 z minus 1 plus b z plus 0.2 z minus 1 plus c z plus 0.8 z plus 0.2, that is equal to this type of equation. Now we have to put, simplify this equation. So we have to simplify the constant term. So a plus b plus c is equal to 1, minus 0.2a minus 0.8b plus c is equal to 0, and minus 0.8a minus 0.2b plus 0.15c is equal to 2. So simplify the equation number 1, 2 and 3. So from 2, c is equal to this. Put the value of c in this equation number 1. So we can get the value, we can get the equation like this manner, 1.2a plus 1.8b is equal to 1. Now next we have to, from equation number 3, put the value of c in this equation. So we can get minus 0.768a minus 0.072b is equal to 0. Now from equation number 4, b is equal to this, 1 minus 1.2a upon 1.8. Now put the value of b in the equation number 5, we can get the value of a. Okay, so e is equal to minus 2.833. Clear? Now the next is we have to put the value of a in this equation b, so we can get b is equal to 2.4442. You have to calculate the value of b. And third, c is equal to 0.2a plus 0.8b. Put the value of a and b in this equation, we can get c is equal to 1.3889. Okay, same method you have to apply for the second term, z in this bracket minus z square plus 1.84z upon z plus 0.2, z plus 0.8 and z minus 1, and you have to find the again the value of a, b and c. Okay, so for the second term we can get the value of a is equal to here 0.567, b is equal to minus 1.9556 and c is equal to 0.3889. Now put the value of a, b, c in the matrix x of z. So we can get this type of matrix. Clear? Now what is our target? We have to find the value of x of k, and x of k is nothing but the z inverse of x of z. So we can take the z inverse of this term. So taking z inverse x of z, so here you can see that the term minus 2.833 is constant, z upon z plus 0.2, the z inverse of z upon z plus 0.2 is equal to minus 2.2 raised to k, plus 2.442 in this bracket minus 0.8 raised to k plus 1.3889. Okay, 1 raised to k, so we have to not write the value of 1 raised to k. Then the second factor is 0.567 minus 4.2 raised to k minus 1.9556 minus 0.8 raised to k plus 0.3889. Now what is y of k? Okay, so in this example, Here you can see that y of k is equal to c into x of k. Okay, so put the value of c and x of k in this equation. So we can get x of k and c is equal to 1 0. So put the value of c and x of k in the equation of y of k. So we can get y of k is equal to minus 2.833 minus 0.2 raised to k plus 2.442 minus 0.8 raised to k plus 1.3889. So using the Z transformation method, we can also find the value of state transition matrix x as well as we have to find the value of x1 of k and x2 of k. So first of all, what is the step? First of all, we have to find the value of Zi minus Z inverse, that is equal to adjoint of A upon mod of Zi minus Z. After that, we have to find the value of x of k using the matrix x of z, and for x of z we have to use the initial condition and the input is applied for this particular system, and using the x of k find the value of z inverse of x of z, we can find the value of x of k, and then we have to find the value of y of k. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt, then contact me in my email ID.